Welcome back, learners. My name is Shubhangi Jaipurkar, Assistant Professor, Department of Advanced Management Studies, GS College of Commerce, Vatha. This session, I am going to tell you the human resource planning process. Friends, when this process starts and how it starts. So, if there is a person A who wants to start his business, the first thing he will have to see, what is the plan? Where you want to go in the next 3 or 5 years, or maybe as a region in the next 10 years. He will have some plans which will be divided into categories of objectives and goals which are short term. So these plans will be achieved with the help of some resources. How these resources will come into the picture? Somebody will have to bring them, and there where our process of human resource planning starts. So, the first stage in planning we do is analyzing the objectives and goals of the organization. So, first is analyze organizational plans and goals. If this plan says us that, yes, every month we have to produce 10,000 units of the production. So how this 10,000 units will be produced? How many people will be required them to produce? It will not just be the production process. Obviously, these products have to be sold also. So the finance department, marketing department, HR, production, these departments will be working together to achieve this target. How many people in every department will be required, that will be calculated, and thus the plan says that, okay, analyze the goals and plans for the organization. Why this have to be analyzed? Because on the basis of these targets, the roles and responsibilities coming for every person will be decided. So the second stage will come as analyze how many people we currently have in hand. So analyze the current inventory of human resources available. Friends, this will be different for the companies have had different phases in their business. Suppose there is completely new company, it will have to have all the resources for the first time. There are some established companies whose organizational goals may change or the situation may change, like pandemic, and if they have entered into new segment, the manpower planning will be done accordingly, and the number available on with the company will be different. So how many people, so where we, what we want to do? Okay, we want to produce 10,000 units per unit, 10,000 units per month. How they will be achieved? We need people. These people are working in different departments. Different departments will give the number of people required. So, suppose this is the number of people required. And currently we have these many. So, there is a gap. Now, the third stage comes. How to fill this gap? And before that, we will forecast demand. To fill this gap, how many people are actually required? So match the future requirements with the current ability, and we can see, yes, this is the gap. So next process comes is to fill this gap. How this gap will be filled? We will have to bring new people in the picture. So estimate the manpower gap. Yes, this gap is there, and how much is it? Gap. So this estimation will tell you what kind of skilled people with what abilities are required in various departments. So hiring or removing decisions can also be taken at this department, at this stage, because there may be some people who are going to get retired. See, the forecasting of demand will tell you two things. Either the gap can be a deficiency, or so this is required, this is available. The available can also be on the greater side, that we may have surplus. So what can we do in the surplus state? If we require, suppose 1000 people and we are having 1100 people with us, so these 100 will be either removed from the system or they will have to be shifted to some other departments, or you will terminate them. So how the termination process will go on? Some of them might get retired or might get transferred. So hiring or removing decisions can be taken on the basis of this gap analysis, telling us whether we have a surplus or deficit. If there is a surplus, we will remove them. If there is a deficit, we will fill them. So next stage is formulating the action plan. If you know there is a surplus or deficit, what is the next stage? You will take some actions. That action plan itself will be an employment plan. Or retire. So in case of deficit, we recruit. Sometimes the deficit can also be filled with the current manpower by training them or enhancing them or developing them from one stage for the other stage. So training may be for new ones or existing workers, and transferring from one department to another. So this is how we can fill the deficit. If there is a surplus, we can deploy them, we can transfer them, or we can lay off the employees. Once the formulating or action plan or employment plan is ready, we implement this plan. Okay, so decision of removing or recruiting has been taken. If you have deficit and you want to recruit, start recruiting. That means there will be a selection procedure, there will be interviews through which the company will hire people. Fine. Or train the existing ones if not hiring. So training and developing for new and existing people will form a part of this implementation plan. Last stage will be monitoring and controlling the feedback. Once these people are into the system and they have started working, remember the purpose, they will have to work to achieve the targets. So after their work, periodically that work will be assessed and we'll see whether it has met the targets or not. So the last stage will be monitoring, controlling the plan and taking feedback. This feedback is an important source to tell whether the goals have been met or not, if people are finding any difficulties to perform their job, or some people are not performing, they are going beyond expectations in their performance and they have to be rewarded. So this is the whole procedure. After monitoring, control and feedback session or feedback procedure, again the gaps will be found out whether. So what we do is, we compare the standard with the actuals. So compare this, again find the gaps and tell the HR department what can be, is there any deficiency and or is there any surplus. So this is the whole process of human resource planning. This is how the companies plan. Please remember, students, that this process, although not standardized but almost the same for all the companies, where the variations will come, that will be the situation of the company or the phase of the company in which it is there. So maybe there are some very established companies who may have their human resource acquired through internal references, and there may be some new companies who are giving opportunity to the new people without any experience as well. So it will depend on the company what kind of people it is hiring, but this is how the process goes. So let us revise again. Analysis, analyze what we want to do. So first stage, organize what are the organization plan. Once you do that, just see what you have in hand. If there is a deficit, bring new one. If there is a surplus, lessen it. Again, put them into the production process and see if the plan is going as per the standard or not. If it is not going, improve it. This is it for the day. In the next lecture, we will meet you. We'll meet soon. I will bring you another management lesson. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.